Hey folks, how's it going? Here in Britain we have some amazing takeaway options. Whether it's a dirty kebab after a skinful of drink or a cheeky vindaloo and a Netflix night in, there's an option to suit everyone, and it's not just the same old fish and chips. In today's video we'll take a wander up the East Coast for a classic northeastern takeaway, the chicken parmo, and I'll share with you my spin on the recipe that you can whip up in no time in the comfort of your own kitchen. Loosely based on chicken parmesan, this is definitely not one for when you're on a diet. A succulent, deep-fried, breaded chicken breast smothered in lashings of creamy béchamel and topped with melted cheese. The calorie count is not for the faint, or indeed weak-hearted, but when it comes to a once-in-a-while treat, the folks on Teesside really know their onions. Or chicken. Whatever, this is the Teesside Parmo. Time waits for no one, so let's get to it. Once we start cooking, today's recipe goes by real fast, so let's start by getting ourselves set up. I measured out 40 grams each of butter and flour here for our roux, and now to bread our chicken, we'll just grab some ready-made breadcrumbs. Panko would be awesome here, but my local store didn't have them today. We need plenty of surface area for breading our chicken later, so into a large dish these go. This is about 175 grams. To that I'll add 10 grams of onion salt for flavour and seasoning, and I'll follow that with a good strong pinch of smoked paprika. This will add both flavour and colour to our finished crumbs. If you're feeling saucy, you can throw in a few dried herbs here. Herbs de Provence would probably work, maybe something like marjoram. Totally non-traditional, but probably very good. Onto our chicken. This is a couple of breasts I got from our local butcher. Get to know your local butcher, much fresher than the supermarket. Let's put these into a Ziploc bag to avoid splashing juice all over the kitchen, and then grab a heavy base pan and bash them flat. I'm told that traditionally these will be very thin, maybe a centimetre, but I prefer them a bit thicker, so maybe 1.5 to 2 centimetres. When frying at home, it's easier to stop them drying out when they're not quite so thin. To bread our chicken, we're going to use a simple dredge in flour, egg and our seasoned breadcrumbs. You'll make your life easier if you have plenty of space to work with, so use good size bowls for both the eggs and the flour. This is maybe 200 grams or 7 ounces of flour, which should be enough for 4 parmos. Start with one egg, you can always crack in another later if you need it, and then we'll just give that a good beat. Let's get set up with a little production line for our breading and go in first with our flour. Turn a few times to get a good coating and then into the egg. Let any excess drip for a second before going into the breadcrumbs. Now we want to make sure we get a really good coating of our crumbs here, so turn the chicken a few times and pile the crumbs on top to make sure you get that flavour into any little nooks and crannies. The last thing you want is any bare bits of chicken. You could do a double dip if you wanted by going back to the egg and then a second coat of crumbs, but if you do this right you should only need a single breading step. Just repeat that for the second breast and these look great. Pop those to one side for later, wash your hands because raw chicken, and let's make a start on the béchamel. So for this we're going to melt the butter that we measured out earlier into a pan over a medium heat, let that bubble and melt until the foaming stops, and then in with our flour. Turn the heat down to low and give that a good stir to combine, then keep stirring regularly for a couple of minutes until it doesn't smell like raw flour anymore. Once that's done, turn off the heat and gradually stir in 500 millilitres or just under a pint of cold milk. I like full fat, but you do you. Add this a little at a time, stirring in completely before adding the next bit to avoid any lumps. Don't be like me, make sure you get those stubborn bits of roux that hide in the corner of the pan to ensure your final sauce is rich, creamy and lump free. Once fully combined, turn the heat back on to low and don't forget to give this a good stir every once in a while as it thickens. Hey folks! This is the first in a series of videos in which we'll wander around the UK looking at the best takeaway dishes Britain has to offer. I'll be sharing with you some simple ways you can cut down on your Uber Eats bill by making them at home. If you're enjoying it so far, do me a huge favour and hit that thumbs up button. It lets me know that you like it, it helps the video spread to more people, and it really helps the channel. If you want to see more videos in this series, check out the Great British Takeaway playlist, linked in the description. Cheers! For deep frying, fill a good sized heavy pan about half full with oil. I'm using vegetable oil today, but whatever high smoke point you have handy will be fine. We want to fry at 170°C, that's 340°F, so let's heat the oil over a medium high heat until just above that. It'll drop slightly when we add the chicken. Fry off the chicken breast for about 3 minutes, turn in occasionally until crisp and golden, and then remove to a wire rack over some kitchen paper to drain. I know some of you get worried about deep frying at home, but as long as you don't leave the pot unattended and take care to keep the heat under control, it's totally safe. If you are really worried, then keep a damp, not wet, cloth on hand, ready to place over the pan in case of any mishaps. After 3 minutes, I can tell from the sound that this is done and the crumbs are looking deep golden and delicious, so it's time to remove this. If you're frying one at a time or in batches as I am, don't forget to test the temperature of the oil and let it come back to just above 180 degrees C before repeating the process with further batches. Once they're all done, let them rest for a few minutes on the rack. This will let the juices redistribute and let them cool slightly, which will help stop them drying out later under the grill. Speaking of the grill, now's the time to turn it on so it can preheat. I always grill on the highest setting, so 250 C, 480 F, convection if you have it. The béchamel should be done by now. You have been stirring it occasionally, right? Once it's nice and thick, give it a final stir and let's grate some cheese. According to my man in Middlesbrough, cheddar is traditional, but I like a mixture of cheddar and low moisture mozzarella for this, as it browns beautifully and has great stretchability. But hey, you do you. So, chicken fried, cheese grated and béchamel done. Let's bring all the elements together on our board. I'll season the sauce with some salt and a little bit of white pepper. Feel free to use whatever you normally use. Nutmeg is somewhat traditional. I'll give this a final stir to evenly distribute that seasoning, and then it's time to assemble our parmos, ready for the grill. For this, I'm using a regular baking tray or sheet pan if you prefer, and the assembly is pretty simple. A fried and rested chicken goes down, followed by a good amount of that béchamel. Making it slightly thicker than usual really helps it stay in place under the grill. I'm watching my waistline, but for the authentic experience, you want a bit more sauce than I'm adding here, maybe 100 grams per parmo, and then follow on with our cheese mixture. Again, I'm watching my waistline, maybe 100 grams if you want to be authentic. A little sprinkle of salt, and under the grill these go. 3 to 3.5 minutes later, depending on your grill, let's pull them. And these look and smell amazing. They're ready to serve right away, and traditionally these would be smothered in garlic mayo or chili sauce and served with chips in the British sense. So go ahead and pair with those things if you have them available. These are absolutely fantastic. I really hope you try this soon as an indulgent treat, and thanks for watching the video.